गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. टुडे इन दिस पीरियड नाउ आई एम कंटिन्यू विद द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन विच इज गिवन इन पेज 51 इन आवर टेक्स्ट बुक. ओके, सो एज इन आवर प्रीवियस पीरियड वी स्टार्टेड दिस वर्किंग विद द पोएम विच इज गिवन इन पेज 51 इन आवर टेक्स्ट बुक. एंड इन दैट पीरियड फर्स्ट दैट क्वेश्चन रीड द फर्स्ट स्टैंजा एंड थिंक दैट वी ऑलरेडी written in our notebook. Then after second that is given, complete the following sentences. Okay, so in this also first and second blanks we completed. Now third one it is incomplete, so now I am going to start with that third. So now you people also be ready with your notebook and now start writing with me. Again I am here not going to write down the whole question, that two, question two, and in this three. Third that is given dash because Macavity dash because Macavity moves much much faster than them. So now we have to complete the following sentences. This sentence, the police fail to arrest him. Arrest him because. Okay. The police fail to arrest him because Macavity moves much faster than them. Then after three. This is question two. Now question three. So you people just open your textbook also, keep it with you, because now I am not writing questions on a board. So you have to note it down, question from your book in your notebook. Yes, direct answers I am going to write down on a board. So question three, it is given, a cat I am sure could walk on a cloud without coming through. Now in the bracket see, Jules Verne name is given. So Jules Verne was a French novelist, poet and playwriter. Yes, so a cat I am sure could walk on a cloud without coming through. Which law is Macavity breaking in the light of the comment above? Write down answer. You have to note it down, this question, in your notebook, and then after write down answer. Question 3, write down then answer. Macavity is breaking the law of gravity. As the statement is given and our question is that which law is Macavity breaking? The law of gravity. After this, question 4. Question 4 is, read stanza 3 and then describe Macavity in 2 or 3 sentences of your own. So you have to read it out, stanza 3, and then after we have to describe Macavity in 2 or 3 sentences of your own. Yes, so stanza 3, that is, Macavity is a ginger cat. He is very tall and thin. You would know him. You would know him if you saw him, for his eyes are sunken in, his brow is deeply lined with thought, his head is highly domed, his coat is dusty from neglect, his whiskers are uncombed, he sways his head from side to side with movements like a snake. And when you think he is half asleep, he is always wide awake. Now we have to write down this given stanza, and from this given stanza we have to now write down two or three sentences about Machiavelli. So first of all, you people just write down here question and then after start your answer. Machiavelli is very tall and thin. His head is highly domed and his eyes are sunken, that is deep set. He never combs his whiskers or dust. After that continue again. I tell you one time more, you have to write down question from your textbook in your notebook. Okay, so note it down, don't leave the space as it is. Or dust his coat, he sways his head from side to side like a snake. So after reading third paragraph, now we have to write down 2-3 sentences about Machiavelli. Yes, now see question 5. Say false or true for each of the following statements. Question 5, that is, say false or true for each of the following statements. Now write down first statement, or we can say the first sentence. Machiavelli is not an ordinary cat. So here I am only write down answers. You people just note it down, the whole sentence first properly, and then after write down answers. So the statement is true. Yes, then after 2, Machiavelli cannot do what a fakir can easily do. So this statement is false. You have to copy that complete sentence and then after write down answer. So second one, false. Then after Third, Machiavelli has supernatural powers. Yes, so given statement is true. And when it is clearly clarified that you have to write down true or false, then it must that you have to write down true or false only. Don't do that sign, right tick or false tick, because it is clearly clarified. Yes, in question. Now, fourth one, write down fourth sentence. Machiavelli is well dressed, smart, and bright. False. Then after five, fifth, that statement is given, or the sentence is, Machiavelli is a spy, a trickster, and a criminal all rolled in one. Yes, it's a true statement. So you have to note down all the sentences, and then after you have to write down these answer. Okay. After this, sixth question. Question 6. Having read the poem, try to guess whether the poet is fond of cats. If so, why does he call Machiavelli a fiend and monster? Fiend, that is a devil. So means what we have to do? Having read the poem, we already read the poem. Yes, we discussed also about the poem. Now, we have to guess whether the poet is fond of cats. And if so, why does he call Machiavelli a fiend, that means devil and a monster. So, note it down this question first. Then after, write answer. Yes. The poet is fond of cats, but he does not, like Machiavelli. As he fond of cat means he likes cat, but he does not like Machiavelli, as he is a big criminal, he dodges the police every time. So he calls him a fiend. Means always he creating such a confusion, yes, for the police of Scotland Yard. So that's why means poet says that Machiavelli is a fiend, that means he is like a devil. Not a comparison we can say, but he giving that name to the Machiavelli. Then after question 7, has the poet used exaggeration for special effect? Find a few examples of it and read those lines aloud. So note it down this question first, question 7. Question 7 is, has the poet used exaggeration for special effect? Find a few examples of and read those lines aloud. So just we are going to write down, we are not reading that line, or you people just read it, note it down this question, then after answer yes, the poet used execration for special effect. He has tried to show that Machiavelli has supernatural powers. The following lines support it. Now, if our answer is yes, then we have to means write down some lines, that line supporting our answer. He breaks the law of gravity then after his power of levitation, that means flying on the sky without any support, make a fakir, so flying too high without any support, that is levitation. His power of levitation would make a fakir stare. Then after third one, you may seek him in the basement, means you are trying to find him in the basement, underground place. You may look up in the air, you may look up in the air, but I tell you once again, Machiavelli is not there. Clear? So now here this poem textbook portion is complete. Now we are going to start unit 3 from workbook. Read it out once, whatever we just now completed, that exercise part from textbook. Now give heading. Now we are going to start workbook in that unit 3. So in our workbook page 19C, that first exercise it is given, study the following picture descriptions and answer the questions that follow. So about this picture also, already we read it when we are doing that our textbook explanation part. Ram Mohan Roy, a learned man from Bengal, understood what was wrong with the country. So let us not despise ourselves. Our Asian culture is great and we are capable of greater achievements. Superstitions have been ruining us. He told his wife Uma, cows are of different colors but the color of their milk is the same. So as we found, cows are having some different colors but the milk having only one color, that is white. Different teachers have different opinions but the essence of every religion is the same. So by saying that statement, he want to give that information about that different teachers have different opinion, their thoughts are different but essence of every religion is the same. He was attracted by science and modern knowledge. Knowledge should be practical and scientific. He started newspaper but the suspicious British stopped them in 1823. He crossed the seas and went to England to see out, made the British powerful there. He told them, "We accept you as a ruler." So when he went out to England, what he said there, told to British that we accept you as the rulers and you must accept us as subjects. But you must remember the responsibility a ruler owes to his subjects. Means if we are ready to accept you as a rulers, then you have to also be ready to accept us as a subjects. And you know, you means you have to be familiar with your responsibility too for us. Yes. Now some questions are based on this description. First question, who was Ram Mohan Roy? Write down that first. Study the picture, the following picture descriptions and answer the questions that follow. Now write down question 1. Question 1, who was Ram Mohan Roy? So you have to note it down, this question from your workbook in notebook. So write down now answer. Ram Mohan Roy was a learned man from Bengal. Then after question 2, what did he think about Asian Indian culture? Write down this question. Answer 2, he thought that the ancient Indian culture was great and they were capable they were capable of greater achievements. After this, question 3. What according to him has been ruining us? Write down question 3. Answer. According to him, superstitions have been ruining us. After this, question 4. What similarity did he draw between cows and different religions? He said that cows were of different colors, but the color of, milk was the same. In the same way, different teachers had different opinions, but the essence of every religion was the same. But at the end means what we getting, that is the same only. What they teach is that their styles are different, their thoughts, their opinions are different, but what they are teaching, that we getting at the same only by all. Yes, so student, in this period up to this much, now further we will continue in our next period. So note it down, all the questions as I tell you. Okay, now further we will continue in our next period. Thank you, goodbye.